On Starbucks, following its disappointing earnings results last week, founder and former CEO Howard Schultz is urging change at the coffee giant following those results.
The coffee chain plans to raise the price of brewed coffee by as much as 20 cents at locations across the country.
Once upon a time, Starbucks was the undisputed king of the coffee kingdom. You'd see that green mermaid logo everywhere, like a signal for people needing a caffeine fix. But trends change fast, and big empires can fall. Now, with the economy shifting, Starbucks is up against a tough challenge. Both investors and coffee lovers are now extremely worried. Brewing trouble, the Starbucks recession. Saga Starbucks, once the reigning monarch of the coffee kingdom, is facing its toughest battle yet as the winds of recession blow hard against its doors. The economy isn't doing so hot, and Starbucks is feeling the heat. They recently had their first drop in sales since 2020, which has raised serious concerns. So, what's causing all this trouble? Well, it's not just Starbucks. It's a sign of bigger problems with how Americans are spending their money. With the economy struggling, people are beginning to rethink their pricey coffee habits. The CEO, Lachman Narasimhan, says fewer people are coming in because consumers are being more careful with their money and are unsure about the future. And it's not just Starbucks feeling the pinch. Other fast food giants like Subway, KFC, McDonald's, and Taco Bell are also seeing their sales drop. It's like a chain reaction, showing that there are some serious issues in the economy. People are making excuses left and right, blaming everything from lousy weather to tough competition. But let's face it, most people are holding onto their cash tighter than ever, and businesses are scrambling to hook those shrinking dollars. Fast food joints are in a fierce showdown for customers, each trying to grab a bigger piece of the pie, which seems to be getting smaller by the day. Starbucks used to be the big cheese in the coffee world, but now it's got some serious competition from local coffee spots. These cozy joints offer a more personal touch and a vibe that Starbucks just can't replicate. Starbucks isn't as untouchable as it used to be, especially with its heavy reliance on drive-through and mobile orders. The numbers paint a rough picture: declining transactions, rising prices, and a growing dissatisfaction among consumers spell trouble for Starbucks. Despite growing its store count, the company saw a 7% decline in transactions in North America, a troubling sign of changing consumer preferences. But perhaps the most damning indictment of Starbucks' woes lies in its stock price. While the broader market soared, Starbucks' stock deteriorated, a clear signal that all is not well within the coffee giant's kingdom. The latte line, customer traffic takes a nose. In Starbucks' history, few moments have been as sobering as the recent revelation of declining customer traffic. Starbucks is facing a tough time. Their customer numbers have dropped a lot recently, which is a big deal for a company that thrives on people coming in every day for their coffee fix. It's the first time they've seen sales go down since the chaotic days of 2020, and fewer people are buying stuff overall. But it's not just Starbucks feeling the pinch. The whole fast food and drink industry is struggling. It's like a wildfire spreading through a dry forest, affecting every part of the food world. So, why are fewer customers coming in all of a sudden? Well, according to Lachman Narasimhan, the big boss at Starbucks, it's because people are being more careful with their money and feeling unsure about the economy. In simple terms, when money's tight, a $7 coffee is usually the first thing people cut from their budget. It's a common story. When the economy gets shaky, people spend less on things they don't really need. And in a world where everything seems to be getting more expensive, fancy coffee often ends up being the first thing people give up to save money. A wave of challenges. But Starbucks's troubles aren't just limited to shifting consumer preferences and economic headwinds. No, these challenges would disrupt even the most seasoned corporate titans. Rising costs, the bitter aftertaste of inflation. First, Starbucks is in a tricky situation with inflation creeping up. Everything from the materials for making coffee to paying their workers is getting more expensive. Now, they've got two not-so-great options: either swallow those extra costs themselves and see their profits shrink, or hike up prices and risk making their loyal customers unhappy. So, it's like walking a tightrope. They have to be super careful not to raise prices too much, or customers might decide to just brew their own coffee at home. But if they keep prices too low, Starbucks won't make enough money. Labor pains, the barista revolt. But that is not all. Starbucks is also struggling with a labor crisis of its own making. In recent years, the company has faced a wave of unionization efforts from its baristas, those daring foot soldiers on the front lines of the coffee wars. The reasons for this barista revolt are as varied as the drinks they serve. Dissatisfaction with wages, concerns over working conditions, and a perceived lack of respect from management. Whatever the cause, the result is the same: a broken workforce and a disruption to the smooth operation of Starbucks' vast empire. Competition brews, the rise of the indie coffee shop, and let's not forget the ever-present threat of competition. While Starbucks may have once reigned supreme, the coffee industry has become increasingly crowded in recent years. From hip, indie coffee shops to upstart chains nipping at Starbucks' heels, the competition for the caffeine-addicted masses has never been fiercer. These independent coffee stores offer a different kind of experience, one that caters to a more discerning palate and a desire for something more authentic than the mass-produced fare of the corporate giants. With their emphasis on quality over quantity, these indie shops have carved out a loyal following, one that may prove difficult for Starbucks to sway. Rising above the challenge. So, what does a coffee giant do in the face of such daunting challenges? Well, if Lachman Narasimhan's words are any indication, Starbucks is not going down without a fight. One key strategy is a renewed focus on innovation and reinventing the Starbucks experience. Gone are the days when a simple cup would suffice. Today's consumers demand more, and Starbucks knows it. Starbucks is actively exploring new menu items and drink concoctions, as well as reimagining the spaces where we enjoy our caffeine fix, in an effort to stay relevant and appeal to a new generation of coffee enthusiasts. But innovation isn't just about what is in the cup. It's also about how we order and consume our beloved beverages. In an increasingly digital world, Starbucks is doubling down on technology, embracing mobile orders and loyalty programs, and even exploring the brave new world of artificial intelligence and automation. While the idea of a robot barista may seem wrong to purists, Starbucks understands that staying ahead of the curve means embracing the tools of the future, even if they challenge the very essence of what it means to be a coffee shop. Of course, no corporate turnaround would be complete without a healthy dose of cost-cutting measures. Starbucks is no stranger to this bitter pill, and the company has already announced plans to trim the fat, streamlining operations, and cutting back on non-essential expenses. But cost-cutting is a double-edged sword. While it may provide a short-term boost to the bottom line, it also risks alienating employees and customers alike. After all, no one wants to see their favorite barista replaced by a machine or their beloved store shut in the name of efficiency. The human touch, remembering the heart of the brand. Amidst all the talk of innovation, cost-cutting, and digital transformation, it's easy to lose sight of what made Starbucks great in the first place: the human connection, the sense of community, and the simple pleasure of a well-crafted cup of coffee. As the company navigates these turbulent waters, it would do well to remember the very essence of its brand: the warm embrace of a familiar space, the friendly banter with a knowledgeable barista, and the comforting ritual of indulging in a little slice of caffeinated heaven. Starbucks has built an empire in these seemingly small moments, one that surpasses mere transactions and tips into something far more powerful: the human desire for connection, comfort, and a brief respite from the chaos of the world outside. Lessons from the Starbucks storm. The fickle nature of loyalty. One of the most striking revelations from this crisis is the unstable nature of customer loyalty. For years, Starbucks has cultivated an almost cult-like following, a legion of devotees who would happily brave the longest lines and pay absurd prices for their daily fix of caffeinated bliss. However, the shifting economic conditions have tested that loyalty. Suddenly, those same customers who once scoffed at the idea of a home-brewed cup are now reconsidering their priorities, opting for more economical alternatives in the face of mounting financial pressures. It's a harsh lesson in the reality of consumer behavior. Loyalty is a fickle mistress, easily swayed by external forces beyond a brand's control. In the end, even the most passionate devotees will succumb to the call of financial sense when the circumstances demand it. The road ahead. As Starbucks faces the challenges ahead, the road ahead looks uncertain. Will the company learn from this tough time, staying true to itself and reconnecting with what made it successful? Or will it opt for quick fixes and temporary solutions, repeating past mistakes? Only time will tell, but one thing's for sure: the whole world is paying attention. This crisis gives us a peek into the bigger picture, how consumer trends change, and the tricky relationship between brands and customers. Time will reveal whether Starbucks comes out of this storm weaker or stronger. We'll find out if Starbucks comes out of this as a bad taste or a refreshing boost. Starbucks' story serves as a lesson and inspiration for any brand striving for greatness in tough times. In the end, it is not the storm that defines us, but how we weather it. In the grand scheme of things, Starbucks' current problems might just be a small bump in the road for them. It's like a little hiccup in the big story of how Starbucks has become a huge deal worldwide. Tough times show what a company is made of, either making it stronger or shaking it to its core. As we see what happens next, one thing's for sure: coffee will never be quite the same. Whether Starbucks comes out on top or disappears, its impact on how we drink and see coffee will stick around for a long time.